Welcome back to Kenya. Early December last year, we left our camp in Loita Hills with a lot of luggage to go on a trip to the Maasai Mara and to Mbita. After a short pit stop in Narok town, we left the dusty roads of Narok to go on a long stretch of bumpy roads with animals left and right of the car, beautiful landscape towards the Maasai Mara. The main reason for traveling to the Mara was to fix a not working solar pump, which is close to the local camp, and also to have a rest for the whole journey from our home to the Mara and then to Mbita takes about 12 hours. The camp here in the Maasai Mara is definitely one of our absolute favorite spots in Kenya because it has probably the most spectacular view over the national park. We've spent 3 days working, resting, taking showers with a view and spotting animals from above, just like elephants, buffaloes, hippos, wild beasts, zebras and many, many more.
Into the world we're reaching out to show them who you are. So living water flowing through, can we thirst for more of you? Fill our hearts and flood our souls with one desire, just to
back on the road, and this time towards Mbita, a little town right at the Lake Victoria. Andre, who is the co-founder of Walking with Maasai, is also chairman of another organization which has a camp right at the lake. There we went to complete another project, which is to build another solar tower to produce power for a water pump.
Mississippi Delta is shining like a national guitar, and I'm following the river down the highway through the cradle of the Civil War. I'm going to Graceland, Graceland, Memphis, Tennessee. I'm going to Graceland. And poor boys and pilgrims with families, and we are going to Graceland. My traveling companion is 9 years old, the child of my first name. Not reason to believe we all will be received in Graceland. She comes back to tell me she's gone. As if I didn't know that, as if I didn't know my own name. If I never noticed the way she brushed her hair from her forehead, you could say losing love is like a window in your heart. Everybody sees you're torn apart. Everybody sees the wind blow. Oh, Graceland, Graceland, I'm going to Graceland. Our pilgrims and poor boys with families, we are going to Graceland. My traveling companions of ghosts and empty sockets, I'm looking at ghosts and empty. But I've reason to believe we all will be received in Graceland. There's a girl in New York City who calls herself the human trampoline. Sometimes when I'm falling and floating and twisting and turning, I think, oh, so this is what she means. She means we're bouncing into Graceland. Memphis, Tennessee, I'm going to Graceland. Poor boys and pilgrims with families, and we are going to Graceland. I may be obliged to defend every love, every end, and maybe there's no obligations now. But I've reason to believe we all will be received in Graceland. Let's go, go in Graceland. I'm going to Graceland.
I'm not good at saving, but I'm good at holding on, like the way the sparkle never leaves your eye. I'm not good at leaving, but I'm good at getting gone, and I'm giving all I have to get me by. take me by the hand, you know I'm...
Oh, monkey's going in the back. See the monkey. Ooh.
I give it all I can. Yes, I'd swim the river up and back if it make me all day. I'd swim the river up and back if it make me all day. I'm not good at talking, but I'm good at speaking up. Telling mom and pop is proud of me. I'm no good at joking, but I'm good at cracking up. So kick your shoes up on the bank and jump right in. Lady, take me by the hand. You know I'm doing what I gotta do to make you understand. Lady, I'll give it all I can. Yes, I'd swim the river up and back if it make me all mad. Swim the river up and back, baby, make me your man. I'm not good at aims, but I'm taking every shot. Pointing my red arrow at your heart. Yeah, I'm no good at swimming, but I'll give it all I got till I finally float away inside your arms. Lady, take me by the hand. You know I'm doing what I gotta do to make you understand. I'll give it all I can. Yes, I'd swim the river up and back if it make me your man. I'd swim the river up and back if it make me your man. I'd swim the river up and back if it make me your man.
So over the last week I was building that solar tower here. I was cutting, welding all the pieces together and then eventually mounted these six panels on top. And that tower will provide enough power to run a solar pump, submersible solar pump inside the well. These guys are currently digging a little bit deeper.
Asino.
Eh? Hello. Asino, the space is going to be enough.
One is going to dig.
The space is still going to be enough. Let him come. This wall is dirty.
Besides working, we enjoyed this place so much. It is such a beautiful spot in this world. We spent a lot of time with our little man. We sat at the lake in front of our doorstep, watching the hippos, taking a bath in the morning. And yeah, once they had gone or disappeared somewhere, we went in for a swim. One day early morning, before the heat of the day, we went on a boat trip to some bird islands in the middle of the lake.
Trying to leave a legacy with only so much time.
the bird. Living on the surface, and in between the lines, I'm going down to the bottom of the sea until I found the deepest part of me. And if I drown, I shall know that I died free, searching for my destiny without a doubt. I'm going down.
On our way back from the islands, our engine of the boat broke down, and we had, yeah, you can say, the lucky opportunity to explore a tiny fisherman's town while waiting for our captain to find a spare part to repair our engine. Compared to our place where we usually live in Luita Hills, where it is not completely safe to go for walks all by yourselves because of a lot of wildlife, Sue was very happy to go for hikes early in the morning, exploring the neighborhood and all the surrounding hilltops.
Just got to think of me.
After 3 weeks, we had to leave this beautiful place and its lovely people, and we're on our way back to Mbita Hills. But this time, the journey didn't go as smooth as the first time. We had some unexpected surprises, such as the Land Rover breaking down a couple of times, the cargo on the roof that got loose and had to be strapped again, a door that opened itself constantly while driving, and finally the lights of the truck refused to work at night, so Sue had to use her iPhone to illuminate the last stretch of our way back to the camp.
Hello.
It's a bath to go.
A bath to go. Wow, that's useful. So handy. Okay, bye.
Okay.
Yum.
Oh yeah. Yeah, and
oh, you're my Lola.
So now we would like to thank you very much for watching this video and being part of the journey. And if you like, please hit that subscribe button if you don't want to miss any other upcoming videos. And we'll see you next time. Bye bye.